seen all the attention that Russell and Harris got for winning on the nationwide tour. Now you've got something they have, plus you've got $99,000. They don't have that. That's a good thing you can hold over the two of them.
Absolutely, yeah. I mean, they're two ends. I tried to tell Harris to turn pro the week he won the Southern Am, and I tried to talk him into turning pro for Ohio State event, but he doesn't listen to me anymore. He thinks he's smarter than I am. But, no, it was, you know, it's great to be in that contingency with those three guys to definitely win. You know, Kurt won on the Nationwide Tour. Brennan Todd's won. I played with all those guys. You know, it gives you that sense of security that, you know, you've been around these guys, you know, for 5 years, 6 years, playing day in, day out with them. You know you can win. You can play these guys. But you just got to give yourself the opportunity. And, you know, to have the opportunity coming down the stretch and do what I did was, I mean, it was just awesome. It was just, words don't really describe it.
What did you do last year after you finished at UGA? You played mini tours or something?
I did. I played the e-golf tour. It's a great mini tour run out of North Carolina. I played, I want to say, 8 of their events. And my goal last summer, I joined the tour. And if you're top 20 on their money list, they paid for Q school, which is kind of a check you don't want to stroke at the end of the year. And I successfully did that. I think it was the last event, really, that I was playing in with them for the money list. I had to come in the top three, and I ended up winning. Beat Harmon out. You don't have to put,
yeah.
you don't have to put that in there. But snuck up and came back and get Harmon and ended up getting Q School paid for. And was playing well at the time and just kind of played well through Q School and came up a couple of shots shy. Get my PGA Tour card and watch Harris and Harmon just go on by me there. But I knew I had full status out here and knew it was going to be a great, you know, great learning experience, great years, nothing to overlook. It wasn't disappointing out there. It was kind of a bittersweet type of deal that, you know, I went from mini tour to a full nationwide card, nothing to overlook. And like I said, I mean, I was pumped up. I mean, I told my caddy and my agent at the time that, you know, I was like, I get to go play in Athens now. And it's just going to be exciting. I know there's going to be a lot of great crowds and family going to be there. And it's to win it, I mean, it's just, I mean, feelings, it's unbelievable.
What was the winner's check on the e-golf tour?
I think I made $30,000 for my win. I mean, it was great to me. I was fresh out of college. I actually had a second place that was like 15, and then I won. I think I ended up making, you know, $65,000 for my 9 events that I played mini tour wise. And thought I was on top of everything, you know. I thought I was just king of the hill, to be honest with you. And then to get my nationwide tour card and, you know, make a cut and you finish top 20, you get $10,000. I was like, wow, this is better. This is everything. And then to win, I mean, hadn't really sunk in yet, but, you know, it's just building blocks and it just keeps getting bigger and bigger. And it's just a great feeling to see that, you know, all the preparation and all the facts and hard work paying off, you know, to what it is now.
Liz said y'all went and ate together one day. Liz said y'all went and ate dinner together one day.
We did. We went and ate dinner, I believe, Friday night. Yeah, we went to Porterhouse, good spot in town, one of my favorite steak places. And no, we're actually good buddies. He played the same high school as Harris. And I've known Luke, I guess, since I was in high school playing AJGA. Hacker tried to get him to come here, but he overlooked. He thought he was better than that, so he went to Vanderbilt. But no, he's actually a good buddy of mine. His caddy's a dear friend of mine. I was ecstatic. We got to celebrate his win this week. His caddy came up to me and said, "Now it's your time." And to see him on top of the leaderboard and both of us fighting out, it was good. It was awesome to see, and him come congratulating me. It was awesome. I got to follow his win up here. It doesn't get any better than that.
You see guys this year on both this tour and the PGA Tour get to lead the last day and have trouble holding it. From your standpoint, was it a little bit better for you that you got able to come from behind and just wore down to finish without worrying about trying to protect the lead or anything like that?
Absolutely. I mean, like I told my caddy, I mean, we're just freewheeling. We have nothing to lose. We just need to go out and get off to a good start and just try to get after it on the back nine, because you never know what happens out there on this back nine. You can make some birdies. You can also make some big numbers. Fortunately, I got to stay away from those big numbers today. And it was, you know, it's just, just played solid all day and just gave myself a bunch of chances, so I was pretty happy.
For a first win, you know, to win it like you did on that last shot, that's, you know, guys make 2 foot putt to win tournaments. That's pretty good to win.
No, it doesn't get any better than that. I mean, I wish it was a 2 foot putt. It would have been a little easier. But, no, I mean, those are the finishes that are highlights, you know. Not that I'm knocking in a 2 footer in the highlight, but to finish a hole out of bunker shot, I mean, to win a golf tournament, it doesn't get any better than that. A chip in or a hole out, I mean, it's just a heck of a way to end off your day and to know that you've done everything you can that day to give yourself a chance to win. And that's just how I felt, whether I would, you know, play, go into a playoff, Luke would beat me by one. I just knew I did everything that I could to, you know, be in that spot, in the number one spot.
Knowing Luke, like you said, you do, did not surprise you that he played the 18th so aggressively. I mean, he'd already got tied with you after the birdie on 17. He could have maybe went for the playoff. And he said, well, maybe I should have went 3-wood, but I wanted to go driver. I mean, does that fit his personality?
It does. I mean, he's a great ball striker, hits it long. I mean, it was a little into the wind, and 18's probably the longest hole out here, mm-hmm. but I'm surprised he didn't hit 3-wood. But, you know, he won last week. He's hot. He's tied for the lead this week. I mean, I'm sure he's been driving it good all day. Wasn't really thinking. I mean, when you're in that position, you're not thinking about a bad swing. I mean, you're thinking about getting a wedge in your hand, making another birdie, and taking the outright lead. Sure, that's what he was thinking. I know it's unfortunate that he kind of had a stumble on the last hole, but I know he played well all week. And, I mean, back-to-back weeks of first and second, I mean, that's nothing to be disappointed about for him, for sure. But, yeah, I mean, he's an aggressive player. That's just, we both are. I mean, I kind of thought, I contemplated a 3-wood a little bit, but, you know, it's like there's no point in a 3-wood. you got to be aggressive. You can't. I'm not very good at laying up. I never have been. So, I mean, I was going to hit a driver, and that's kind of his mentality as well. So, you know, play to your strengths, and then just adjust your game from there.
Anything else?